shall be hit.
Pastor came. And the Bonke preached. After he preached, he said, okay, I am calling the pastor to come and pray for you from South Africa. The pastor from South Africa took the mic and said, close your eyes. And we just pray and say, Father, you are holy, you are faithful. After he said amen, he gave the mic to Renan Bonke.
After amen,
Renan Bonke said, I said, you must pray for the sick. He said, I'll pray for them tomorrow. And then Pastor Renan Bonke said, okay, tonight we're not going to pray for the sick. Pray them tomorrow and bring them in numbers. That's tonight we'll see. Those who are lame will be able to walk. The people will be well. The brethren shall rise. Bring them in numbers. They went home, people.
By high.
The following day, people came in large numbers. When pastor was going to fetch the other pastor where he was sleeping, he passed at the tent and he saw a lot of people. He found the pastor who has gone to pray for people wearing his suit, holding the bag, and he said, I am going home. He said, I paid for you to be here, and you promised me that you are going to pray for the sick. The pastor said, the Holy Spirit said, I must go home. He said, what kind of the Holy Spirit is that? Who says you must go home when you have to pray for the people? I have to listen to him. He left. Renan Bonke went to the tent. When he got there, he found the intercessors. Powerful intercessors. Praying for the service. For the service that started. But they are praying for a service. He said, I've got good news and bad news. Which one do you want me to start with?
He said, bad news.
He said, Pastor from South Africa is gone. He said, if those are the good news, the bad news, then what could be the good news? If those are the bad news, what could be the good news? Because we don't see the good news. We don't see the good news. He said the good news is that Jesus is here. He said, okay, we hear you, but you see these people. He left them and prayed.
I
got what the prophet.
I am a prophet.
He started to preach. People are sitting the way you are sitting. Waiting to be healed. After he preached. He said, now I'm going to pray for the sick. Remember this, that man who has never seen God working in miracles in his life. He has been preaching for long. But he has never saw anyone get healed. And he had the Holy Spirit speaking to him. Pray for the blind. And the devil said, what if they don't see? And he said to the devil, as long as I can pray for them, if they see or they don't see,
they see business.
He started with the blind. He said, I want those who are blind. Because people were meaning they did not come in front. He said, those who are blind, touch your eyes. I'm going to pray for your sight. You will be able to see. The first time praying for the people who are sick and expecting the immediate miracle. He said, in the name of Jesus, I open the blind eyes. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
He was quiet. And suddenly there was a noise at the back. I can see the anointing that was waiting for the action. What God is going to do for,
and
we will step up I never knew that I could cast out the demons.
Until
I went out in the tent. I remember I saw a thing. I was a person who can pray.
And
all demons were in flesh.